When you load a preset of a live device on Push, you may want to alter the way it sounds. To do this, you can tweak the different parameters, and in this video, we're going to look at some basic sound design that you can achieve directly from Push. I've selected a track that contains the live device analog. This is a basic subtractive synthesizer, but it has lots of different parameters for me to tweak. The initial and most important parameters are available directly on the screen, and I can tweak them with the encoders directly above the screen. If I want to further edit different parameters, I can go a level deeper by simply pressing the button directly above the display where analog is written. Now, below the display, I can use the buttons to access the different pages of parameters available to me. If I see an arrow, like here, I can press the button directly underneath to scroll through the different pages. I'm going to select the unison parameters. And detune the synth slightly. Some devices are contained in what is called an instrument rack. In this case, the instrument rack contains a combination of live instrument devices and live audio effect devices. The most important parameters of the devices have been mapped to the 8 macros of the instrument rack and are available for me to tweak immediately using the encoders above the display. If I wish to access the individual devices, I can select them using the buttons above the display. You can also add effects to devices. I'm going to go back to my baseline, and by pressing Add Device, I can now scroll to the Audio Effects section and select an audio effect device. I'm going to choose a saturator. And the first preset available in any audio effect device will load the default. I can now use the encoders to tweak the audio effect device. The audio signal runs from left to right, so I can continue adding audio effect devices as I please. This time I'm going to add an EQ3 and load the default. If I wish to change the order of effects, I can simply hold the button above the effect I wish to move the position of, and then use the encoder to move its position. If I wish to switch off an audio effect device, I can hold the mute button and press the button above the display to switch off the device. I also have the possibility of loading VSTs or audio units directly from Push. To do this, I'm going to press Add Device, and I'm going to change the analog instrument device to a VST plugin. I can select the plugins folder and browse for my plugin and load it. The encoders are automatically mapped to the most important parameters of the device. Similar to the instrument devices in Live. And by pressing the button above the display, I can access all the banks of parameters that I can tweak.